Main doubt on homosexuality. Like, is it prohibited in Islam? And why so? Because, from the past 5 years, I've been with so many homosexuals. It's like, their feelings that they have for the same sex or whatever it is, it's so true. I mean, it's like the same kind of pain what we might feel for maybe our husbands or whoever it is. If it's wrong, why is it wrong?
Sisters asked the question that what does Islam say about homosexuality, and if it's wrong, why it is wrong? Allah says in the Quran in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 32, that come not close to adultery, for adultery is an evil opening other routes to evil. Besides that, Allah says in Surah Araf, chapter number 7, that telling to men that do you practice your lust after men in preference to women? That means homosexuality is prohibited in Islam, in the Quran, because Almighty God made the human beings. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Rum, chapter number 30, verse number 21, that He has put love between the hearts of husband and wife. Almighty God has made the human beings in such a way that they love the opposite sex. Generally, naturally, no human being loves the same sex. I'm talking about the love which is required in husband and wife, not the platonic love which you have between your brothers and between your sisters. Now, initially, there was a research which said that homosexuality is genetic. So during question answer time, somebody asked me, the way you're asking, if homosexuality is genetic, then how is that human being to blame? It came from his parents, so why is he to blame? Like you're saying, if someone loves someone else, so why should he be blamed? I said, this is a research. This is a hypothesis. It's not a fact. And later on, we came to know that this hypothesis was wrong. And the person who propounded this hypothesis, he himself was a homosexual. So homosexuality is not genetic. It comes, today science tells us, how do homosexuals evolve? Because what Almighty God has given permission for a human being, what's permitted? You get married, do nikah, you can have sex with your wife. And Islam says that while doing, having sex with your wife is also worshipping Allah. Because you're preventing the haram, you're not going outside the marital bond to satisfy your urges. That's Islam. Today science tells us, today research tells us, that those people who have multiple life partners outside the marriage bond, as compared to those who only have with the spouses, they enjoy their sexual life much better than the others. And what happens today, when you get tired with it, you go to the Western countries, you have mistresses, 5, 10, 20, no problem. You start then doing unnatural things. When you start doing unnatural things, you don't follow the law of the Creator and you try and satisfy your urges in the wrong way. The moment you keep on doing the wrong way, then you keep on going beyond what is natural, and that's how the person becomes homosexual. It is not genetic, because you go beyond the limits what Almighty God has permitted you. You try other things, you try unnatural things, and finally you land up by saying you no longer enjoy having sex with the opposite sex, so you have sex with the same sex. So sister, because they have broken the law of Almighty God and they do unnatural things, that's how psychologically they become a homosexual. So, but naturally, if you break the law of Almighty God, that's totally wrong. And that's how it lands up a person being homosexual. So they are to blame. And Islam prohibits homosexuality. Even Christianity prohibits homosexuality. Most of the religions are against homosexuals. It's now the Western countries are saying, because in democracy, whatever majority says, you win. Majority wins. In Islam, majority doesn't win, the haq wins. The truth wins. I remember when I had gone to Canada in 1996, the first time I went to give a lecture, in the front page I saw a man kissing a man. A man kissing a man, and it says that they have married each other. Today in Western countries, if I speak against homosexuality, it's a crime. It's a crime. So what we realize that previously, all the countries, homosexuality was a crime. Then some Western countries like Canada gave legal sanction to it. Today, most of the Western countries, homosexuality is legal. Even India, the country where I come from, they're thinking to make it legal. So what we realize, what is truth is truth. Majority doesn't win, what is wrong. And in Islam and most of the major religions of the world, homosexuality is a sin, it's a crime, it will not take you to heaven, it will take you to hell. Hope that answers the question, sister.